Hi, my name is Stephen Haeg with MTS Systems Corporation. Today I'm going to spend some time talking to you about heavy truck durability testing in the laboratory. Suspension and chassis development tools for heavy vehicles. There's a lot of components, subsystem, and system tools available. What are the challenges with heavy trucks? High forces, high velocity. If I've got big forces and they're moving fast, I've got big power. That means big oil flow demand, and that means big cost. And that's been a real challenge in the heavy truck industry. How do we simulate the environment of this very severe heavy truck environment and be able to afford to pay for it in the laboratory? This is an example of a 24 channel light truck test. We can do the same thing with a heavy truck. We can do component tests. You see here an airbag test, 6 degree of freedom airbag test. Here we've got a 5 degree of freedom V-rod test for testing the elastomer system on a V-rod. Here we've got an axle bending test. This can be a two-axis test up to six-axis test depending on the requirements. Lots of different specific tests for components. Truck leaf springs are very often tested in the laboratory. This one has up to 5 degrees of freedom on it. This is an example of a truck cabin suspension durability test. This simulates the floor of the cabin. This is the suspension from the cabin down to the frame. And so we can move around this floor of the cabin simulator with actuators to simulate the motions that occur on the road. And then we're testing all of the suspension system for dynamics, for fatigue and durability, for capability to transmit vibrations or isolate them in the laboratory. This is an example of a truck suspension test focused primarily on the airbags. You notice, by the way, there's a big safety cage around this thing with this wire. That's because airbags are known to explode sometimes and they shred shrapnel. So we've got a wire cage around that so we can keep all the pieces contained. This is a multiaxial hub coupled road simulator called the 329HTMP. It has 4 or 6 degrees of freedom, operates up to 35 hertz. Pretty good for a truck range. Most of the testing ends around 25 or 30 hertz. This is a 6 degree of freedom configuration. We've got steer and camber as well as vertical, lateral, longitudinal, and torsional. This is a 6 degree of freedom tester we call the 329HTHP, or high performance tester. It does 6 degrees of freedom to 50 hertz. One of the things you notice right away, if you take a look at these two systems, we'll go back a slide here. We look at the reaction frame for a 35 hertz system. It's not so heavy duty. We get up to 50 hertz. It's not just the system that gets upgraded, it's the reaction frame. So the whole system's got to get beefier as we raise the operating frequencies. People don't always think that through. So that's another hit on the cost for these systems to operate properly. We don't want any resonances in the frame in the operating frequency range. We can also do a tandem axle test, such as you see here, testing a bogie for a heavy truck. We've got the pair of axles, very common in the heavy truck business to use tandem axles. This simultaneously tests all suspension components, linkages, and frame interface. In a laboratory environment, with a fixed axle, we can test all the way down to so-called zero frequency for turning and twist stitches and things like that, as well as broken concrete, pave, general transport. We can split this test into two individual axle tests and run completely separate independent tests at the same time by breaking these main beam in half and putting in these new abutments in the middle. Now, it's not just the test rig that's important. It's the application and usage of the rig that is important. We have to think through, it's heavy truck components. Once in a while, they're going to break when we're testing them. It's not a production test part. We're going to not be able to go down to the local auto parts store and say, can you give me another lower control arm? Those are prototype parts. Secondly, there's probably going to be engineering decisions. If we broke something in the laboratory, we may have to make some changes to design. We may have to look at analysis. That all takes time. In the meantime, we're not running our machine, we're not generating test data, so it's costing our company a lot of money, and we're not making any money on that. So this customer said, I want to be able to not only load the system in 6 degrees of freedom at 50 hertz, I want to be able to change the specimen in one day with three people and follow all the local labor laws. That includes 3 coffee breaks and lunch. It's 3 coffee breaks because the customer was in Sweden, where they have 3 coffee breaks every day. So we set up what we call this zipper system for pallets, where we've got slots here instead of bolt holes. So we've got a row of bolts with a nut plate. You release those with air, wrench, zip, 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 slide off the nut plate, do the next five, slide off the nut plate, and you go your way along until everything's disconnected. You leave that suspension on a stand, you move the cross beam over to the next suspension that's already prepared with the pallet mounted, you drop it on, you zip your nut plates back on, you lift it up, you take it back over to the system, you set it back down, and you put your nut plates on the ends. And the quote I got from the customer when we did this is, well, not only did it work, it set in place, and when we were done, it went click. He said we were done in 6 hours, and we had time for yet another coffee break. So he was very pleased with all of this. It used to take him more than a week to change specimens in one of their home-built rigs. MTS is working on some new heavy truck test multi-axial products. This is an example. We're going to come working on a 50 hertz heavy truck performance rig that's completely mounted on a flat floor. The existing systems go into the floor with what we call mini pits. That's proved to be a challenge for some customers. We wanted something a little more universal to fit existing laboratories, so we're in the final processes of developing this system. It does fixed axle or free body tests. The hub adapters here retract 300 millimeters because some of these heavy truck axles have outboard gearboxes that we have to clear to change the specimen. So you see here the clamping system and adjustment system. Integrated static support reduces hydraulic oil flow demand by supporting all the static load of the truck, reducing our piston areas for reduced overall oil flow. Real-time tests require high power and high performance. For example, it takes about 2,000 liters a minute of HPU per heavy truck axle to simulate rough road events. Must accelerate the mass of the specimen and the loading fixtures. Is real acceleration required for all tests? Is a real good question to ask. We need to review the sources of heavy axle loads and find out what role do these various inputs, suspensions and dampers and other things, have on the loading system. We know that the suspension springs provide the highest load to the truck. Suspension linkages also see high forces. We need to identify the contribution from acceleration, velocity, and displacement to see what can we do to reduce the oil flow demand. Maybe we can run slower or do something and still get the damage. So we got to determine the damage contribution from each type of motion, the acceleration, the velocity, and the displacement, and then find some acceptable trade-offs between input power and specimen damage so that we can afford to run this test in a realistic amount of time in the laboratory. We need to modify the input waveform if possible to minimize system power. Well, a fixed reaction suspension test doesn't rely on body motion to provide forces. It's all fixed. We're going to move the suspension against the frame. So that's good. We don't have to excite this realistically in a free body test to get it to move right. We can choose how we're going to do that. So let's look at axle mass distributions. Here's a heavy drive axle. We've got a what we call a pumpkin, the differential in the center, and versus a front axle or an undriven axle, which is just kind of usually a tube or an I-beam across the sides. So let's take a look at where are the forces in this. We got spring forces are related to displacement. That's displacing the springs. That's your big hit there on a truck, is displacing the springs, the largest forces that go into the frame. We've got damper forces related to velocity, and we've got inertial forces related to acceleration. The inertial forces are largely along the axle itself. So as we accelerate it, we have an inertial force on the axle. Undriven axles have very little acceleration forces or inertial forces because the mass is small. So what do we want to look at? The displacement-induced forces of this Kx, spring stiffness times the displacement. That pushes the spring against the frame. Spring forces are the largest in the suspension. So we want to be careful to maintain our displacement time histories accurately so spring forces get reproduced. What about our velocity? Well, that provides the damper forces, but the damper forces are much, much less than the spring forces. Probably don't have significant damage content for the chassis. If we want to test the bracketry and connection system of those, we could test those at a component test level. So let's say we may not need velocity accuracy to test our truck suspension and frame. Now we've got acceleration forces. If we're looking at our suspension and frame, most of the inertial forces are reacted here within the axle itself, and they very rarely fail due to this inertial load. They fail much more from bending, which is a much higher force.